Since antiquity, numerous religious beliefs and cults have evolved alongside mankind. The study of ancient artifacts and shrines give archaeologists the opportunity to confirm what is only mentioned in scriptures and find out more about extinct religions. In this video, we are going to take a look at some of the remarkable discoveries made by religious archaeologists. We begin with the Sarum Ordinal Page. When a librarian at England's University of Reading found a page of writing hidden in an archive, she immediately knew it was something extraordinary. Both sides of the paper bore red paragraph marks and black lettered typeface. This identified the incredibly rare page as belonging to a book printed by William Caston, who started the first printing press in England. Printed between 1476 and 1477, the Sarum Ordinal or Sarum Pad was a handbook written in Latin by St. Osmond, an 11th century bishop. It was a guide for priests on what to wear and which Bible text to use during religious festivals. At some point, the page was ripped from the now missing book and used to strengthen another spine. It remained there for 300 years until a librarian rescued it in 1820. However, not realizing it was an unknown Caston leaf, he studied until another 200 years had passed. Despite its age getting torn and pasted into another book, the leaf is in good condition. The only other remnants of a Caston printed Sarum Ordinal are 8 pages kept at the British Library in London. Next, the Donor Stone. In Western Galilee, the town of Parkin is around 2,000 years old. During recent renovations at the ancient synagogue, a large artifact was found. Inside the courtyard was a limestone pillar bearing 2 inscriptions in Hebrew. Carved during Roman times, the 1,800-year-old column was curiously placed upside down for some reasons. Researchers have studied the engravings and have concurred that they appear to be a list of names honoring those who had made donations to the synagogue. Parkin is deeply steeped in Jewish history, and the exact location is still a bone of contention. However, some experts believe that the stone enriches the settlement story during the Roman and the Byzantine eras, and that the artifacts proves the site is indeed the Parkin community mentioned in the ancient scriptures. To find evidence that strongly supports one of Galilee's most significant sites is a historical step for Israeli archaeology. The earliest Buddhist shrine. Legend has it that the Buddha was born under a tree at Lumbini in modern-day Nepal. Depending on the tradition, the year was 623 BC or closer to 400 BC. Most Buddhism schools prefer the latter. By 249 BC, Lumbini represented one of the religious most sacred sites. Recently, archaeologists burrowed underneath a central shrine. What they found baffles everybody. They were stunned to discover the brick building stood on an older wooden structure. Everything pointed to the timber rings as being a holy Buddhist site. The design was near identical to the most recent shrine. In the middle, they found 3 roots surrounded by post holes. This indicates that a wooden railing once circled the Buddhigraha or tree shrine. The clay floor had seen heavy foot traffic, possibly from worshippers. Befitting Buddhism's no-killing stance, there were no signs of sacrifice. Scientific studies place the Buddhigraha at around 550 BC. For most traditions, this could revise the Buddha's birth by more than a century, and although more analysis is pending, the site is a good contender for the earliest Buddhist shrine ever found. The Mother of Pearl Menorah. In 2017, excavations at the ancient Roman city of Caesarea in Israel produced discoveries almost on a daily basis. King Herod built a temple there in the 1st century BC and dedicated it to his patron Augustus Caesar. During its day, the temple dominated the port, and some of the finds within its walls were a partial Greek inscription and an altar. However, it was only when restoration work was being done nearby that the most significant find emerged. A small slab of mother of pearl was found. Carved on the tablet surface was a six-branched menorah. The artifact was unique for its precious material and Jewish iconography. Experts are almost certain that it was once part of a box. More specifically, a container that likely held a Sefer Torah scroll. This handwritten text holds the first five books of the Old Testament and is fundamental to Jewish law. The 1,500-year-old carving was created during the late Roman Byzantine era and shows that Caesarea had a Jewish population during that time. Mithraism on Corsica. Mithra was a mysterious Indo-Iranian god whose following took root alongside Christianity in the Western world. Christianity is well documented, but almost nothing is known about Mithraism except that a primitive religion worshipped a single deity and was probably all male at first. The best chance to study it comes from sanctuaries dedicated to Mithra, and one was recently found in Corsica. In 2016, archaeologists swept the area after local authorities wanted to build roads near Mariana, a Roman town from around 100 BC. It was then they found the sanctuary's antechamber and worship room. This was a proof that Mithraism was practiced in Corsica. Artifacts ranged from the bland oil lamps and pottery to a rare marble tableau showing Mithra himself sacrificing a bull. Some items, such as a broken altar, received damage in antiquity. The ancient Christian center at Mariana cannot be directly linked to the destruction, but it is likely that there existed a mutual tension. The two religions competed for followers, and Roman Emperor Theodosius I, favoring Christianity, outlawed and persecuted the growth of Mithraism. The funeral garden found. Egyptologists had long suspected the existence of gardens for the dead. Inside ancient tombs, murals sometimes show such gardens. In 2017, one was discovered at a necropolis on the Dra Abu El Nagar Hill in Luxor, ancient Thebes. Found outside the entrance of a 4,000-year-old tomb, the garden was a neat rectangular structure, 3 meter by 2 meter by half a meter high. Inside were rows of 30 centimeter square blocks. A corner bed holds a tamarisk shrub and a bowl with fruit, perhaps given as an offering. Two trees flanked the garden, and more probably stood at its raised center. Additional research is needed to find out what else grew in a grid, but experts believe the plants were chosen based on their connection to Egyptian religious beliefs. The unique garden was the first time an iconography was confirmed by a physical discovery, and the find could also reveal what Thebes environment, botany, and religion entailed during the crucial time when the kingdoms of Upper and Lower Egypt merged. Images of a beardless Jesus. Archaeologists got more than they bargained for when they investigated the ancient city of Castelo in southern Spain. Between the ruins were glass sheds with images. When reassembled, a history-changing plate from the 4th century emerged. Although about 20% of the artifact remains missing, there was enough to identify it as a plate used to serve Eucharistic bread. But it was not the plate's papers that shocked the archaeologist. Together, the shards revealed the images of a beardless Jesus wearing a Roman toga. With him were the Apostle Paul and Peter, also clean-shaven and swathed in togas. Each man's hair was also cropped short. Around this time, Christianity often faced Roman persecution, and any visual reference to Christ used a symbol such as the shape of a fish. This discovery could force a rewrite of the religion's history in Spain and how much Roman influence occurred during early Christian art. Since it was made of glass, it is likely that it was forged in Ostia, near Rome, and it remains one of the earliest images of Christ and the Apostle Paul ever discovered. So what do you think about this? Let us know in comment section. For more interesting biblical archaeology discoveries, please check the playlist here. Subscribe to this channel and like this video if you like it. See you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.